You're kind of art and you're it's amazing art and amazing talent. So I want to know for how long you've been doing the art, doing the, this
children's books. Or, yeah. So I've been doing children's books. I graduated in 2008 from Bournemouth University.
Nice.
And I've been drawing books ever since. I've been doing it full time for about 4 years now. So yeah, I've been drawing since I was tiny though.
Right. The Little Adventures of Mr. Philip, I mean, I saw the book, it's a very interesting book, the sketches and drawings are very nice. So what can you tell about the book?
So it's about four children and they have a little club in their back garden that they made up themselves. And it was inspired originally from when I nannied part-time in London for some children. So it's about them using their imagination and just doing very childlike things and lots of nature. So.
Very nice. So tell us about the Stick and Fitch book. I mean, this is the new first edition.
Yeah.
I saw the sketches, very wonderful. So I want to tell you about the story, about how did the idea come up?
So this one's actually Philip's idea. So I just illustrate this one, which is actually quite a nice comparison compared to the collaboration of the Fitch books. Sally Stick and Fetch are a detective duo. Stick is her dog, just a very normal pet, and she can actually understand what he says though, so no one else can, they just hear woof woof. So they have a very special relationship, but they're not very good detectives, they get everything a bit wrong, but it's funny.
Because the idea, I mean, so for any book for children or adults, time when you see the kind of sketches, attract the readers to see it, so
yeah.
It's a very interesting concept.
Yeah, I mean it's two colour inside, so it's quite vibrant and punchy, and that's quite fun to do as well. It's the first time I've illustrated a fiction book, so it's very different to picture books.
Cool. So during your career, I mean, we do sketches for like stories and stuff. Where did the inspiration from? I mean, the references.
A lot of it just things I see every day, books I read, cartoons I watch. I watch a lot of children's cartoons. And just everything, a lot of people they can draw from life, things they see, and I tend to draw everything from my head. So just sitting with pen and paper and just scribbling until something appears, really.
Incredible. You know, through the years, the story of the child has been evolved, like, you know, from small idea to bigger and more deeper stories.
Yeah. So I often start with the character and think about what they might be like. And design them and think about things that might happen to them, and then the story tends to come from that often. Yeah.
Interesting. So, when you make the story, but so people will draw characters, they write about the plot of the story.
Yeah.
And make it. So, when you write a sketch story, how do you know what the space and the character of the story is to?
So, for example, the fiction book, I'll read the text and I'll do a storyboard, especially with picture books, you storyboard every page. And the most important thing in the text, so you'll draw that for each page, or the funniest thing, something that might be the most visual, you'll start with that and just draw a really rough sketch. And then you take that to the publisher and your designer will say yes or no. And then I go on a light box and trace it with a brush pen. And turn it into the final art.
What's your advice for the new talent and the drawing?
Just keep drawing, really. Just draw as much as you can every day, and just make sure you're enjoying it. Use media that you enjoy using. A lot of people use digital now, but if you still like using paints, watercolors, just do that. Just practice, practice, practice. And sharing your work online as well is quite important, just showing it to people, really.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.